Hello everyone, today we are going to see a new topic, that is IP version 6 and IP version 6 addressing. So this comes under third unit of your computer networks. So IP version 6, it is the latest version of internet protocol. So this, using this IP version 6, you can easily identify the devices across internet. Okay, so when you want to identify any device in the internet, you will use a unique address that is called IP version 6 address. Okay, so previously we were using IP version 4, which we were using across the internet to identify the devices. It was 32-bit, it is a 32-bit addressing. Okay, this will support around 4.3 billion devices. This was support around 4.3 billion devices. Okay. However, the growth of internet and personal computers, smartphones, and now Internet of Things need more number of addresses. So IETF, that is Internet Engineering Task Force, they have recognized, and in the year 1998, they have created a version called addressing, new type of addressing called IP version 6 addressing, where instead of using 32-bit address, they have used 128-bit address to support 340 trillion addresses, okay, or devices. So IP version 4, it will have only 32-bit address, it will support only 4.3 billion devices. So we need more number of addresses due to the growth of internet. So IETF in the year 1998, they have created a version, new type of addressing, that is IP version 6 addressing, which will have 128-bit address, that which can able to support 340 trillion devices. That is how this IP version 6 came into existence. So this IP version 4, IP version 6, it will have 8 group of 4 hexadecimal digits. They will be separated by columns. So we will see the representation now. So the main reason for migration from IP version 4 to IP version 6 is the small size of address space in IP version 4. So because of address depletion, so we have converted the version from IP version 4, we have moved from IP version 4 to IP version 6. So this IP version 6 have solved all the problems of address depletion in the future. Okay, so how it can be represented? Usually computer normally stores the address in binary, but actually this, since this IP version 6 is 128 bits, it is cannot be easily handled by humans. So several notations have been proposed to represent this IP version 6. So the two notations have been represented over here. The first one is binary representation, where you will be representing the 128 bits in binary numbers in either zeros or ones. Second notation is hexadecimal notation, where it is called as colon hexadecimal. Here we are going to divide this address into 8 sections. So you can see there are 8 sections over here, each made with 4 hexadecimal digits, and they are separated by colons. So you will be dividing the entire 128 bits into 8 sections. So you can see 8 sections over here, and they have been represented each with 4 hexadecimal digits, and they are separated by colons. So you can represent this like this. Okay, this is how you can represent your IP version 6 notation. Next we will see the abbreviation in IP version 6. So in when you're representing this IP version 6 in hexadecimal format, it is very long. So many of the digits, if you're having 4 zeros, so what we can do is we can abbreviate this address. So if you're having the IP address like this, FDEC:40, so I have represented only 0 over here, :0:0:0, and again one more hexadecimal digits, and :FFFF. So I can represent this, I can shorten this IP address like this, FDEC::: so all the zeros, it can be shorten it, and we can represent double colon, and then BBFF:0:FFFF. So this is called zero compression. So here we are going to reduce the number of digits in your IP address by representing it like this. So we are going to compress the zeros over here in your actual IP address. This format is called zero compression. We will see how IP version 6 is represented in classless addressing. In classless addressing, it is represented in a notation called CIDR. It is nothing but classless. We have already seen when we have discussed in IP version 4. It is classless inter-domain routing. Inter-domain routing. So when we want to represent in classful addressing, we can represent the simple IP address. When we want to represent in classless addressing, we should use a slash notation, and the number of bits that can be considered as prefix can be given over here. So this is how we will represent this IP address in classless notation. The IP address of 128 bits, and which can also be represented in hexadecimal format over here, slash, and here the number of bits represent how many number of bits we have considered as a prefix. Okay, this is your CIDR notation. Next, we will see some examples. So here they have given you some address, and you have to convert that into a notation called IP version 6 address notation. So the first one is an address with 64 zeros followed by 64 ones. So when we represent in an 8421 format, when it is all one, it is nothing but F. That is why 64 zeros are represented like this and 64 ones are represented like this. So this is the IP version 6 format for this particular question. Suppose if they are asking an address with 128 zeros, all numbers will be represented in zeros. Okay, when they have given all the numbers in by ones, 128 ones, when you want to convert it to hexadecimal format, everything that hexadecimal digits will be represented in F. So this is how you have to convert the binary form into hexadecimal form. Okay, you understood this? See some abbreviations for the following address. Suppose if they have given 40:40, and then FFF:0s followed by 000s. So this can be short. We can shorten this IP address and we can represent it like this. So 40s can be represented by 0:, and these 40s can be represented by 0:FFF. Then it is followed only by 0. So we can represent it by :. So this is how what we can do is we can shorten your IP address. The next one is 1234:2346. Then you have zeros, and again lastly it ended with 1111. So when you are going to shorten this, you will get 1234:2346. So all your zeros can be represented as :. At last we have 1111. This is how it will be shortened. Like this is how you can shorten your IP address. Okay, see the addressing types in IP version 6. Okay, there are three. It will support three addressing type. One is unicast address, second one is anycast address, and third one is multicast address. Coming to unicast address, so here the packet will be sent to the intended receiver. So using one single interface, if you have a source and you have a destination, so the packet will be sent through one interface and it will be sent from source to destination. So that is not a problem in case of unicast. In case of anycast addressing, suppose you have a group of computers, okay, and here you have a sender. So what happens is this packet will be delivered to any one of the member. Okay, there will be any one of the member, the packet will be delivered. From there, it will be sent to all the groups of the members. So there will be one single point of contact which will be communicating with the sender and it will be receiving the packet. That is anycast address. So here it will all the addresses, all the computers, they will share a single address. Okay, single address. And only one packet will be sent to the most reachable node in that particular network. That is anycast address. Coming to multicast address, here also you have group of computers, but the difference between this anycast address and as well as multicast addresses, in anycast address, only one copy of the packet will be sent. One copy of packet will be sent to any one of the member inside the group. But here there will be each member of the group will receive one copy. So that is the difference between multicast address. So here what happens is, here also it will be sent the group. So once if you are going to send a packet from the source, it will be sent to all the persons inside the group, but every group of the member will get the duplicate copies of the packet. But here only one packet will be sent out from the sender, and from it will be sent to the most reachable node in the group, and from that packet will be sent to all the groups in the members. But here in multicasting, what happens is a sender will send a packet, but it will be sent, that packet will be sent to all the persons inside, all the group of the members, all the group of the members inside the group. So it receives, every member of the group, it will receive a copy. That is the difference between multicast address and any cast address. You all understood this? The address space, okay, like the address space of IP version 4, IP version 6 is also divided into several blocks and with varying size, and each block is allocated for specific purpose. Okay, first we will see the one type of block, that is global unicast address. So what do you mean by global unicast address over here is, it is used for one-to-one communication between any two hosts inside the network. So if you want to do any one-to-one communication inside the internet, you can use this particular address. So the first three bits, it will be 001, that is 8. If you are represented in 8421 format, it is nothing but 2. So in all zeros, it will start with this number. So we can represent in an hexadecimal format 2000::3. 3 bits is nothing but first 3 bits are used as a prefix over here. So any block which is starting with this, any host which is starting with this 2000 can use this unicast communication, So all the host will have starting address like this 2000: some any numbers you can have over here. Okay, so this is represented as like this. So here you have the 128 bits, it can be divided into 3 blocks. One is prefix, which contains n bits, subnet identifier, which contains m bits, and interface, which contains q bits. This global routing prefix is used to identify the site of your internet, in which site your net system has been connected, and subnet is used to identify your subnets inside your internet, and interface is used to connect, is used to identify the device or interface in the inside your subnet. Okay, this global routing prefix will have 48 bits, and the subnet may contain 46 bits, and this interface can contain 64 bits. Okay, so the first 3 bits over here in case of global unicast addressing is 001. The first 3 bits is 001. Okay, so totally you have n bits, that is 48 bits are there in your prefix. In your prefix, global routing prefix, you have 48 bits, among which 3 bits have been is fixed already. So you have only 2 to the power of 45. You can able to allocate to a private organization 2 power 45 sites, a private organization or an ISP. Okay, this is more than enough to allocate. Okay, next coming to this m bits, if you take, it is already 2 power 16, that is nothing but 65536 subnets you can able to allocate. This addresses can be allocated to, it may be allocated to 65536 subnets, which is more than enough, I think so. Next coming to this interface bits, that is q bits, it is, you have 64 bits over here. So it is 2 power 64, which is also more than enough to allocate the addresses. So here the global, this global unicast addresses is being divided into 3 blocks. One is used for prefix, second one is subnet, and third is interface. This prefix already, first 3 bits fixed, and you can allocate remaining bits to any site, and this subnet you can allocate to this many number of subnets, and last is you can allocate these many addresses inside your internet. So these are all, this is your global, this is how the address space has been divided. Okay, we will see how we are going to map an Ethernet address to IP version 6 address. Okay, so usually this MAC address is composed of 48 bits. See here, it is 48 bits, which is divided into 6 blocks over here, and the first, in the first 8 bits, the 7th bit is 0 over here. When it is when you have your Ethernet address, the it will be local. When you want to convert to a global one, so you need to complement the 0 by 1. The 7th bit of first byte, you have to convert the 0 bit to 1, and you have to, when you are going to convert this 48 bits to 64 bits, you need to add additional 16 bits. Okay, additional 16 bits, which will have the numbers 8 ones, 15 ones followed by 10. That additional 16 bits, it should be added after 3 blocks, and remaining 3 blocks you have to take as it is. So for mapping your Ethernet MAC address to your IP version 6 address, you need to convert, complement the 0 bit of first byte to 1, and you have to add 16 bits, of which 11 ones, that is 15 ones followed by 10, which will be added after 3 blocks, and then the next 3 blocks you have to copy as it is. This is how you have to map your Ethernet physical address to your IP version 6 address. You all understood this? So usually MAC address, it is uniquely, it will be assigned worldwide. When you want to map this your MAC address to your IP version 6 address, IP version 6 address is 64 bits long, but here it is only 48 bits long. So for that, when you want to convert to a IP version 6 address, you need to do these two things. You have to add this additional 16 bits and you have to complement the 0 bit to 1 bit. This is how this MAC address can be mapped to your IP version 6 address. Okay. So in this video, we have seen what is IP version 6 addressing, how it is represented either in binary form or it can be in hexadecimal form. And then we have seen how it is compressed, how it can be represented in zero compression format. And we have seen how it can also be represented in classless addressing with a prefix after represented with slash notation. And we have seen some addressing types, how it is used for unicast application and for any cast address and multicast address. Then we have seen how it is represented as address space, how address space is allocated. So it is divided into 3 blocks. One is a global routing prefix for identifying the site, and this is for identifying the subnet, and last one is for identifying the interface. So which is having 48, 6 bits and 64 bits. At last, we have seen how it can be, how an Ethernet MAC address can be mapped from IP 48 bits to 64 bits. Okay. Thank you all for listening to this video.